Okay, Master Gardeners, come here and tiptoe through the woods with me because I got something really special that you're going to want to see. We're out hiking and I know where there's some native orchids. This is a real common orchid. Take a look at this pretty little showy orchid. I know that many of you have heard me talk about these before. This is Galliaris spectabilis, a common terrestrial orchid that you can find in Harford County. It's real pretty, like 8 inches tall, and it's got a lipped, the little hood on it is a purple color, and then the lower lip is whitish in color. And this one's kind of unique because it is pollinated by insects. It's pollinated by a bumblebee who has to land on there and go inside. Look at how stout the stem is. I'm gonna put my hand in here just so you get a feel for how tall he is. This is the tallest one we found just now. Most of them are more like 6 inches, but this one is easily 9 inches tall, I would say, and still showing some nice color. They're sort of at the latter end of their blooming period, although they do bloom supposedly even into May, well into May, but usually when the canopy of the woodland is just developing, that's when they come out. This happens to be a tulip poplar woodland, and I'm amazed how much these orchids are thriving in here, because if you can see behind me, this is all invasive species. It's all multiflora rose, and these guys are growing in the deep, rich leaf litter on this gentle slope, so it's moist enough. So it's amazing to see. We've had these for many years in this particular area. You have to really watch for them because, like I said, they're always really short and small, and they're white and light pink. So you have to watch for them close. Now, look at some of these little seedlings over here. When they're only 1 year old, it's just a single, one single basal leaf. The mature plant has two of these leaves. There's a bigger one out over here, if you can see those, but these are little seedlings yet to come. And when I look in the other leaf litter over here, I see lots of baby. Look at this little baby. He's still only got one leaf and he's got two flower blossoms on him, which is amazing. And I'm sure a lot of you already know it. When it comes to orchids, they are totally dependent on the mycorrhizae fungi in the area. So it is wasting your time to dig these up and try to think that they're gonna live in your yard, because they're not going to do that. They have to have this symbiotic relationship. And actually, they usually, you can watch some pretty cool videos where they talk about their thieves, their cheaters, because they're not really getting their own food. They're totally dependent on somebody else. But I'll tell you what, that mycorrhizal fungi, it's doing the same thing. It doesn't have any photosynthetic ability at all. And it's a thief if there ever was one. So it's like a cheater connecting himself to a thief. That's what's going on out here. But they're not gonna grow in your yard without that mycorrhizae relationship. But it's fascinating, and even the seedlings, the unique thing about orchids is their seeds, they have no storage in them, no storage of resources and energy. So when the seed falls to the ground, it is totally dependent on that mycorrhizae fungi for that seedling to get started. So that says to me that this habitat in here is a pretty healthy ecosystem. They actually are using orchids nowadays as indicators of how healthy an ecosystem is. So obviously, since we have these little one-year little seedlings, they're healthy. And the fact that they were growing in clumps and things is another indicator that that particular area must have a nice, healthy fungi population. The other thing these orchids tend to like is more of a limey soil, which I'm amazed. I wouldn't think this woodland is more limey. I would think it's acid-like, but there's not many oaks around here. This hillside is all these poplars and things. There's some spice bush mixed in here, and some different types of dogwood cornice. But anyway, pretty exciting. Now, this is endangered in some of the, it's native to all the eastern United States, even well up into Canada. And I looked it up and it's endangered in Maine and in Rhode Island. It's threatened in Michigan and New York, and it's exploited and vulnerable in some of the other states. So no, no, no digging up native orchids. Okay, hope you enjoyed our little hike.